Could Halo Infinite be revealed before E3? Well, possibly, according to this event. We'll stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. So I've been getting some tweets and some questions about this Summer Games Fest that's happening, and I wanted to look a little bit more into it to see what is this event actually going to be like, and is Halo going to be there? Well, they did tease some Halo Infinite within their promotional trailer. So will we see some Halo Infinite news or gameplay even before E3? Possible. So in this video, I wanted to look into it more to get some proper expectations about the Summer Game Fest and see what it's going to be offering for us Halo fans. So if you guys like these news and informational videos and want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo as they ramp up to the release of Halo Infinite, well, make sure you tap subscribe. Let's get right into the content here. So what exactly is Summer Game Fest? Because it starts on June 10th, which is 2 days before E3, which is going to be a huge day for Halo. And we take a look at their website. This is why I look purple, because their website here is purple. And on June 10th, they have a big reveal of a lot of stuff happening with games for the year of 2021. You're probably asking the question, well, what the heck is Summer Game Fest? And it's this June, the video game industry unites to preview what's next, starting with a spectacular kickoff live, hosted by Jeff Nightly on Thursday, June 10th. Keep checking back as events are added to the calendar. Everything can be streamed for free, no badges needed. And here's the YouTube video, just kind of giving you a quick synopsis about everything. It's only like 50 seconds long, link in the description down below, but a very interesting thing when it comes to the surprises, as you did see, we have some Halo Infinite clips right here, but when you say surprises, you hear a clear Master Chief.
We need to fight.
So we know Summer Game Fest will have Halo Infinite there to showcase something. Are they going to showcase what they showed last year? I would highly suggest no, because it wasn't very well received. So we could possibly get some new information or new videos, new gameplay even, about Halo Infinite at the Summer Game Fest. I guarantee you, if Halo Infinite does get revealed somewhat at this event, I will 100% be making videos as soon as it goes live to let you guys know exactly what to expect or what to know from the event, because this is going to happen right before E3. Which, if you guys don't know, E3 happens 2 days after this event on June 12th on Saturday, which we will be doing a live stream watch party of E3. Link to my Twitch channel is in the description down below and also in the pinned comment if you guys want to check us out. We also do stream every Tuesday and Thursday playing some good Halo games. But anyways, so what is there really to expect from this event, really, for Halo Infinite? With this event happening just 2 days before E3, could it actually steal a little bit of thunder from E3 and actually have some big reveals happening this event and not exactly at E3? Because if you look at this list of publishers that are going to be at Game Fest, this is literally everybody, like every possible publisher you can think of is going to be there, which is going to be a huge thing for this event. So this is not just going to be like some throwaway, just kind of like, okay, we'll just try to promote some of our material just to get some more money. Like, this is actually going to be like a significant event right before E3. And most of these publishers here are also going to be at E3, and I'm sure they will all have their own specific kind of events that they want to showcase as well. Because one thing you have to think about with this event happening literally 2 days before E3, that most of the content and stuff that they want to premiere is going to be set up and ready by then. I'm sure right now 343 is polishing up what they want to showcase at E3 this year, and probably by the end of May have something properly set up ready to live stream for the general public. I'm sure many of you remember this trailer right here, which was released on June 24th, which was 2 days before the initial release of E3 back in 2020, but that ended up being canceled. So could we see something similar like this, which is going to be 2 days as well before E3 of 2021 at Summer Game Fest? I think something like this could be very likely, a bit of a tease to get people excited for when Xbox does have their showcase in 2021 for E3, that people just like already had the appetizer and now they're ready for the main course. So we actually could get some decent little content from the Summer Game Fest for Halo Infinite. But will we receive like a huge gameplay reveal, shattering news, lack of content, surplus of content that's going to be in the game? I don't really expect so, but since there's going to be so many publishers talking about so many of their games at this event, And I'm sure most of it's going to be revealed on day one. The following days are just kind of more like promotional stuff, materials, just kind of like talking about specific things that they probably showcase in the beginning of the event itself. So I don't really expect a whole lot to be showcased within here. I don't expect like a release date reveal or anything like that. I think we might get like a solid teaser like we just did last year, like a showcase with the transmission signal that was revealed on the Halo channel. I think something like that could happen at Game Fest, but I don't expect to see any new gameplay or any big announcements or anything like that. It's more just kind of like remembering people like, hey, Halo Infinite's still a thing. Because also keep in mind that this presentation is brought to you by the people who put together the Game Awards. As you can see on the YouTube channel, it has right there, it's on the Game Awards YouTube channel where this promotional thing is. And a lot of times when these kind of people get together, they put together some kind of presentation or some kind of festival like they're doing right here. Most of it's very promotional based. It's almost like an elaborate interactive commercial in a way, rather than anything that will reveal something that will give you some new information about the game. It's more just to promote the games, telling them what's happening, let people know what's going on, what to expect, and really it's all just kind of just fluff and nothing really of actual material that people can work with and understand what's going on. You know, we've been super up to date with Halo, right? As we've been following all the blog updates on this channel, we've been following every little bit of news and leaks and just everything possible about Halo Infinite we've been covering on this channel. But for the general public as a whole, they probably really haven't followed Halo a whole lot since the reveal in July, which was a bit of a disaster in this way, but definitely showcased what some proper expectations could be. And they probably learned that, like, oh, the graphics are bad, and the launch, the reveal of it was like okay. So that's one thing I think 343 really should focus on when it comes to their E3 presentation, is showcasing what they improved, why the delay was necessary, and why this game is going to be awesome, and probably when this game is going to be released. Could we receive a reveal of more campaign stuff? I definitely expect that for E3. When it comes to multiplayer stuff, maybe some flighting information, maybe on that as well. I mean, I've done multiple polls on my channel here, and overwhelmingly, people are more excited about the campaign than they actually are about the multiplayer of Halo Infinite, which is actually kind of interesting. And also, campaign is a much better way to kind of showcase like more bombastic situations, more cinematic things, which kind of get people a little more excited than the multiplayer, which multiplayer gameplay is certainly, when you're playing it, is really fun and exciting, but watching it for a lot of people is honestly like kind of boring. So in conclusion, the Summer Game Fest, what to expect for Halo Infinite? It's going to be there. We might get a little bit of a tease for E3, like a transmission video like we had last year, but other than that, I don't really expect a whole lot from there. But if we do get some serious information or just anything from there, I guarantee you I will make videos about that presentation on this channel. So make sure you subscribe to the channel, guys, to keep yourself up to date with everything going on with Halo. But if you guys miss any content from me recently, or been on the loop for Halo for the last few days or so, check out the videos on the screen right here. I've got a link to all my news and informational videos. So thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. And I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.